First of all, to define what is the spirituality in Islam. Secondly, to explain what is the purpose of spirituality. How do you use spirituality? And thirdly, how is spirituality acquired? How do we get it? We begin with the strange event of the visit of the angel Jibreel alayhi salam when he came as a human being in the masjid in front of everybody, and he came at the very last time, the last being of the life of the Prophet. He is soon to die, and he asked five questions. The first was, what is Islam? The second was, what is Iman? The third is the one that we are concerned with, what is Ihsan? The fourth and the fifth pertain to the end of history. We dealt with this subject in some detail at the lecture, the public lecture at Moeen's Auditorium. Tonight we're going to refine it and deal in detail with one part of the
subject. Apa tujuannya dan bagaimana untuk memanfaatkannya, dan juga bagaimana untuk mendapatkannya. Dan kita akan mulai dengan suatu kejadian yang sangat aneh, yakni kunjungan Nabi Ibrahim alaihissalam dalam bentuk manusia di masjid, bukan semua orang waktu itu pada akhir hayat Rasulullah hadir dengannya. Antara lain, apa itu Islam, apa itu iman, apa itu Islam.
When the angel asked, what is al-ihsan, then the Prophet replied, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said that al-ihsan is an-na'budu Allaha ka'annaka tarahu. The definition of al-ihsan is that you should serve Allah, worship Allah, serve Allah, as though you see Him. As though you are seeing Him. And if you cannot see Him, then surely He is seeing you.
Ya malaikat, Tuhanlah itu Islam. Jawabannya, Anda seharusnya menyembah Allah, berkhidmat kepada Allah, melayani Allah, doa Allah, kami sedang menjawab.
When Musa alayhi salam went up the mountain, Mount Sinai, he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, arini anzur ilayk. Show me yourself, I want to see you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied and he says, lan tarani. No, not possible. You cannot see me. Not with these eyes. Well then, what does it mean that we should worship Allah as though we see Him? The companions asked, O Messenger of Allah, on the day of judgment, will we see Allah? He replied, he asked, do you have any difficulty in seeing the sun when it is noontime? This is Job. He asked, do you have any difficulty in seeing the moon when it is full moon? They said, no. He said, that's how you will see your Lord. That's how you will see your Lord. But the Quran says you cannot see your Lord. And the Hadith says you can see your Lord. How do we resolve this problem?
Belum mulai berbicara dengan Allah, dengan cara Allah memperlihatkan dirinya. Tapi lainnya dengan Allah. Ketika orang kita tidak mungkin melihat dengan mata itu. Jadi apa artinya seolah-olah hidup itu melihat Allah? Kalau sahabat Nabi Muhammad dengan bertanya, pada hari kiamat apakah kita akan melihat Allah? Dan jawabannya, apakah susah kamu melihat matahari? Apakah susah kamu melihat bulan?
Do we have any other eyes besides these eyes? Do we have any other ears besides these ears? University of Singapore says no. No. But Quran says yes. Yes. The Quran says in the ayah which he quoted from Surah Al-Hajj that the heart can see and the heart can hear and the heart can understand. When someone rejects Islam, rejects the truth, then he is a kafir, even if he is driving a Mercedes-Benz. But he rejected Islam, he's a kafir. And for the kafir, Jannah is haram. Haram. Allah says about the kafir, Allah says about the kafir, He says, خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ أَبْصَارِهِمْ غِشَاوَةً وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ Allah has set a seal on that heart. Finished. And Allah has blocked his hearing, internal hearing is gone. But if you speak to the kafir, he can hear you. So these ears are working. Internally he cannot hear. And Allah has put veils before his eyes. If you go before him, he can see you. These eyes are functioning. But the internal eyes are now blind. This is the kafir.
Dia biasa tidak membantu menjawab tidak. Tapi Quran menjawab ya. Menurut Quran, kau pun dapat melihat dan dapat mendengar, dapat mengerti, dapat paham. Untuk menolak Islam, untuk menolak kebenaran, maka orang menjadi kafir. Dan jannah diharamkan untuk dia. Allah mengatakan mengenai orang tersebut bahwa Allah telah menaruh semua tutupan di atas hatinya dan telah mengubah pendengaran batinnya dan telah menaruh tutupan di atas mata kaumnya.
When the Prophet ﷺ went with Burak on Isra and Mi'raj, then in Surah Al-Najm, Allah says, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى. He saw the greatest of all the آيات of Allah. But what did he see? The Quran says in Surah Al-Najm, مَا كَذَبَ الْفُؤَادُ مَا رَأَى. It was with the heart that he saw. The heart can see مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ. The gaze did not waver. No, the spiritual gaze did not waver. مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ. When Musa alayhi salam was on the mountain, and he said, I want to see you. Allah said, well, you can't see me, but look at the rock. Look at the rock. And then Allah directed his divine tajalli to the rock. And I can't translate the word tajalli, so the Sadiq Baru have to translate that. He directed his divine tajalli towards the rock. And the rock exploded. And Musa alayhi salam fell down unconscious. This was not the greatest of the ayat of Allah. No. That one in the Mi'raj, that is the greatest of the ayat of Allah. And when Muhammad alayhi salam was found, so the ayat, مَا زَاغَ الْبَصَرُ وَمَا طَغَى. His gaze did not waver. With what did he see? With the heart.
Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam naik Quran di Isra wa Mi'raj Surah Al-Fatihah. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam yang menceritakan mengenai Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam melihat melihat ayat-ayat Allah yang paling agung, tapi melihatnya dengan tahu dengan hati. Maka tahu dapat melihat pandangan rohani Nabi tidak pernah tetap saja, tidak pernah ke kiri ke kanan. Musa alaihi salam waktu di gunung disuruh oleh Allah melihat batu, dan dia melihat dengan terjalin lillahi, dan itu menjawab sekali untuk menerjemahkan api itu terjalin karena terfokus kepada batu itu. Kemudian batu meledak dan Musa alaihi salam jatuh ke dalam air. Apa itu semang?
And so now the definition, what is spirituality? It is not to perform supernatural acts. That is not spirituality. It is not to be able to travel from here and put a bunker and come back in one night. That's not spirituality. It is not to be able to go up to the arsh and come back down one night. That is not spirituality. It is not to be able to read the minds of other people. That is not spirituality. It is not to be able to perform supernatural things. This is not spirituality. Spirituality is the capacity to see with the heart, to hear with the heart, and you understand with the heart.
Perulangan itu bukan untuk melakukan amalan-amalan yang tidak duniawi, bukan untuk pekerjaan semangat dan kembali yang selalu malam, bukan yang ingat kepada Allah dan kembali dalam satu malam, bukan untuk membaca apa yang sedang dipikirkan oleh manusia. Ini bukan golongan yang dapat Islam, dan bukan untuk mengerjakan hal-hal yang biasanya dikerjakan oleh Allah dan malaikat. Tapi golongan yang dapat Islam yang benar adalah untuk memakai kalbu supaya dia melihat, memakai kalbu supaya dia mendengar, dan memakai kalbu supaya dia
mankind is of all kinds. There are the best of all people, and they are people who can see with the external eyes and with the internal eyes. This is the best of all. And then the next best after that, people like Sheikh Omar Abdurrahman, externally blind, but internally he can see. These are the best of all men. And now we come to the worst of all men. They are those who can see externally, but they are internally blind. And the only thing worse like that, worse than that, is someone from a neighboring country who is externally blind and internally blind. Sheikh Omar is number two. Sheikh Omar Abdurrahman is right here in the American prison.
Jadi manusia sebagai tempat satu yang terbaik ialah yang dapat melihat secara lahir dan secara batin. Kedua, seperti Syekh Umar Abdul Rahman menjadi dia dekat. Muka di luar, tapi bisa lihat dari dalam. Tiga, bisa melihat dari luar dalam Allah, tapi tidak bisa melihat dari luar dalam. Dan yang keempat, seperti dianya oleh seseorang di sebuah negara tetangga dan buta di luar dan buta di dalam.
When Musa alayhi salam said, "I am the most learned of all men," and did not say, "Praise is due to Allah, knowledge comes from Allah," Allah cut off his internal time. And Allah said, "No, you are not the most learned. There's one more learned than you." He says, "I want to meet you." In order to meet the most learned of all men, Musa alayhi salam had to travel to the place where the two oceans met. Majma'ul Bahrain. Majma'ul Bahrain. And there he met Khidr alayhi salam. The commentator Imam Baylawi explains, Majma'ul Bahrain. It is the ocean of knowledge which comes from our external observation, and the ocean of knowledge which comes from our internal spiritual insight. When these two oceans of knowledge are harmoniously integrated in a single individual, the most learned of all men.
Musa alaihissalam mengatakan, saya adalah manusia yang paling pandai, paling berpelajar. Tanpa menguji Allah, maka Allah melelahkan dan mengatakan kita ada yang lebih pandai, lebih berpelajar daripada Anda. Untuk ketemu dengan yang lebih pandai itu, maka Allah Islam harus berkerjaan kepada tempat ketemuan untuk melakukan. Dan menurut saya tempat ketemuan untuk melakukan itu ialah lakukan ilmu keluar dan lapang turun dalam. Kalau sekiranya kita menguasai lautan ilmu yang ini dicapai dengan makanan kami berdua, dengan lautan ilmu yang ini dicapai dengan makanan kami berdua dalam, maka orang ini adalah yang paling
nanti. In Suratul A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivers a terrible warning. وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ. Huge numbers of people are now condemned for Jahannam. What did they do? What did they do? لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. They have eyes, but they can't speak. They have ears, but they can't hear. They have hearts, but they cannot understand. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ. Such people, even with a PhD from the University of Singapore, such people, they're just like cattle. They're just like cattle. Mahumamah. No. They're more misguided than cattle. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمَ الْغَافِلُونَ. These are the ones who are truly heedless of Allah, heedless of the signs of Allah.
Surat Al-Qaf ada peringatan dari Allah, banyak sekali manusia terkutuk dan dibuat ke jahanam atas sebab api yang telah mereka lakukan hingga terkutuk dan dibuat ke jahanam. Karena mereka dulu punya mata tapi tidak bisa melihat, mereka punya telinga tapi tidak bisa dengar, dan mereka punya kalbu tapi tidak bisa paham. Malahan mereka seperti binatang hewan saja, seperti sapi-sapi saja, binatang ternak. Malah mereka lebih tidak mendapatkan petunjuk. Binatang ternak lebih mendapatkan petunjuk daripada mereka. Mereka tidak mau memakai yang telah dianugerahkan kepada mereka oleh Allah.
And so now the answer to the second question. What is the function of spirituality in Islam? The answer is, the function of spirituality is to make you capable of seeing, of recognizing, and of understanding the ayat of Allah as they appear in the world.
Sekarang kita mendatangi soal yang kedua, apa function Islam? Spirituality di sini diterjemahkan dengan Islam. Dan jawabannya ialah untuk membuat anda sanggup, mampu melihat dan mampu untuk mengenal ayat-ayat Allah.
Amongst the ayat of Allah, the most important of all, the most momentous of all, are those which will appear in the last age, the age of Eden. And so the angel asks question 4 and question 5 are questions about the last age. When will the last day come? Question 4. He says, the one who is being asked has no more knowledge than the one who is asking. So next question please. Next question please. No one knows when the last day is coming. So if Ram who says cannot say the last day is coming in 50 years time, he'd be a fool to say that. Only Allah knows. Question 5. What are the signs of the last day? When these signs appear in the world, as big as billboards, and you can't see them, Allah says, you just like cattle. You just like cattle. Number one, that you will see the naked, barefooted shepherds, meaning people who have the intellectual acumen of naked, barefooted shepherds. You will see them competing to build the tallest building in the world. High-rise buildings. This is how they measure progress. Progress, high-rise buildings, PR projects. But Allah says, wrong. The tallest of you in the sight of Allah is the one who has the greatest fear of Allah in the heart.
Ayat-ayat yang paling penting akan nampak pada akhir zaman, pada masa ikan, masa ayat ikan, malaikat kemudian menangis. Yang pasal kelima mengenai akhir zaman. Soal yang keempat, kapan hari celaka makhluk laki itu akan datang? Dan jawabnya ialah yang bertanya lebih jauh daripada saya, atau saya tidak lebih jauh daripada yang bertanya. Dan yang kelima, apa yang bertanda hari celaka teman-teman, dan jawabannya ketika ayat-ayat ini nampak, dan kamu tidak bisa melihat ayat-ayat, kamu tidak bisa melihat petanda-petanda itu, kamu persis bagi binatang, bagi sapi, dan yang cara petanda-petanda ayat-ayat itu ialah gembala tidak berkatul dan lanjang akan saling bersaing untuk mendirikan bangunan-bangunan cakar langit, dan manusia akan menganggap itu sebagai kemajuan, dan mereka akan mengukur kemajuan dengan tingginya bangunan, tapi Allah bilang tidak. Yang paling maju sebetulnya adalah yang takwanya paling besar, paling banyak.
The implications are very important. When you see the skyline with tall buildings, you know there is no spirituality there. When you see the skyline with tall buildings, you know, those who rule are just like cattle.
Nampak atau implikasi daripada ini sangat penting. Ketika kamu melihat garis langit dan juga bangunan-bangunan tinggi di situ, maka kamu akan tahu bahwa tidak ada spirituality, tidak ada Islam di situ. Dan orang-orang yang berkuasa di atas mereka sebetulnya hanyalah seperti binatang.
The one who is blind eternally, he goes kampung. Kampung, no high-rise buildings. He said, this is backwardness. Backwardness. He goes to city. Nothing about here. He goes to the city and he sees high-rise buildings. He said, this is heaven. This is internal blindness.
Jadi yang hukum di dalam dia pergi ke kampung dan dia bilang ini ketinggalan zaman. Kemudian yang mulia di dalam dia pergi ke kota dan dia melihat bangunan-bangunan yang tinggi-tinggi dan dia bilang ini kemajuan dulu. Sebetulnya dia kota saja dan yang dia anggap kemajuan adalah ketinggalan.
Then the Prophet says, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, that you will see that the slave woman will give birth to her mistress. I don't have the time to explain that tonight. But I did it as a lecture at Moiz, so you ask Ustaz Iqbal for the tape recording of that lecture, and you'll get the meaning of a slave woman giving birth to her mistress. But briefly, for the slave woman to give birth to her mistress, you need, number one, the economy based on riba, so that she is now imprisoned in a new economic slavery. Number two, you need the feminist revolution and its struggle for women's liberation, so that the night will try to become day. And therefore, women will lose their fertility, kata babies. And number three, you need dukhar, smoke, the environmental pollution, and the corruption of food. Genetically re-engineered food. And consequence of that, it affects fertility. And so since she cannot have any babies, the slave woman, her womb will now become a factory. When the baby is born, baby goes first class. Mother remains as a slave. So slave woman has given birth to her mistress.
Nabi mengatakan, juga perempuan akan melahirkan wanita. Tapi tidak ada waktu untuk menjelaskan ini. Tapi setelah saya jelaskan tentang jawabannya yang sebenarnya, pendek kata, kamu memerlukan satu ekonomi yang menjelaskan lebih baik. Kemudian kamu memerlukan
and the state of Israel is restored. mother of all Islam. If you cannot see and recognize and understand that sign, then you do not have spirituality. You can be a Sufi Sheikh with 10,000 followers, but you do not have spirituality.
Dan dengan spirituality atau Islam, kamu sendiri dan kamu sebenarnya yang tentang sosial di dunia. Tapi ada disebut di Quran ayat-ayat atau pecahan-pecahan lain, misalnya pengembalian orang-orang yang diundang Israel kepada tanah suci dari kaum sebelah, mereka telah diusir dari tanah suci itu dan sekarang mereka kembali. Dari kaum setelah Allah telah menyatakan negara Israel dan sekarang sudah kembali kembali.
Spirituality has another function. It is not only to be able to see and recognize and understand the ayat of Allah as they appear in the world. Spirituality also has the function of making you capable of anticipating events which are to occur. For example, those of you who have studied the subject of Dajjal, the false Messiah, you will now be able to anticipate that there is an event coming, perhaps within the next 5 to 10 years. A momentous event in the world of politics. The foreign ministry doesn't know about it. The foreign minister doesn't know about it. That the United States of America will no longer be the super state, the ruling state of the world. That the state of Israel is going to become the ruling state of the world, taking over from the United States. When that event occurs, then those who have anticipated it on the basis of spirituality, they will say, praise be to Allah who guided us to the truth. For the rest, they will have mud on their faces. They will look like donkeys on that day when they have been pretending to be the ones who possess the true knowledge, and they are opposing and attacking the ones who have spirituality.
Well, function lain daripada Islam ialah membuat kamu sanggup mengantisipasi atau bisa merasakan atau merasakan gerasa yang memberitahu sesuatu akan terjadi sebelum sudah terjadi. Kalau kamu pernah mempelajari masalah Dajjal, maka mungkin kamu bisa mengantisipasi bahwa akan datang, akan terjadi suatu kejadian yang luar biasa, besar dan dahsyat. Mungkin dalam masa 5 sampai 10 tahun lagi, yakni Amerika Serikat akan diganti sebagai superpower negara adidaya oleh negara Israel. Dan orang yang bisa melihat dengan mata kau dari dulu, mereka akan berpikir yang alhamdulillah kepada Allah yang telah menunjukkan kebenaran kepada kami. Dan yang tidak bisa melihat dengan mata kau luar itu, walaupun mereka adalah Syekh Sufi yang terbesar dengan 10,000 penganut, mereka akan mudah, mereka akan nampak dengan lumur atau mana tanah campur air
tanah yang mud, tanah yang mud. pointed the dustbin at the crib. When Israel becomes the ruling state in the world, then a Muslim army will destroy the state of Israel. And then Islam will take over and Islam will become the ruling state of the world.
Ketika Israel menjadi negara adidaya yang berkuasa di dunia, maka semua tentara Islam akan menaklukkannya dan Islam negara Islam Israel akan menjadi negara adidaya yang berkuasa di dunia.
Yes, spirituality allows us to anticipate something else. Something. Do I have it? You have an initial one. You think it forward. Yeah. Okay, for money. We think this is fraudulent. They will say that. We say this is haram. They will say that. We say this is riba. They will say that. We say this is going to collapse. You can't even buy Roti Canai with it. You can only use it as wallpaper. We say that is coming soon, within the next 5 to 10 years, and it will occur at the same time that Israel becomes the ruling state. And then there will no longer be any cash transaction anymore. It'll only be plastic. When that day comes, and what we have anticipated comes to pass, we say, praise be to Allah who guided us to this. For they will have mud on their faces on that day, who opposed us, and they will look like donkeys.
Uang kertas, mata uang mana saja, uang kertas adalah palsu sebetulnya. Uang kertas adalah haram. Kami mengatakan uang kertas adalah palsu. Uang kertas adalah haram dan uang kertas adalah riba. Dan sistem uang kertas akan ambruk dan akan dipakai hanya untuk hiasan diri saja. Dan mungkin dalam masa 5-10 tahun ketika Israel menjadi negara adidaya di dunia, setelah sistem uang kertas telah ambruk, maka tidak ada transaksi tunai sama sekali dan akan diganti dengan transaksi plastik. Dan kami akan mengatakan pada waktu itu, alhamdulillah, tapi orang-orang yang tidak setuju dengan kami, muka-muka mereka akan ditutupi dengan bambu.
If these are the functions of spirituality, then spirituality is very important. How can we get the heart to see? How can we get the heart to hear? How can we get the heart to understand? If you are a teenager and you are here tonight, 17 years of age, 18 years of age, 19 years of age, I want you to listen. If you have a boyfriend or girlfriend, I want you to listen even more. How do you get the heart to see? This is the third question.
Soalan yang ketiga, bagaimana hari ini bisa melihat, mendengar, dan paham? Apa yang harus kita lakukan supaya tahu bisa melihat, mendengar, dan paham? Sudah jelas, spiritual ini Islam sangat penting. Kalau sekiranya ada di antara hari ini, anak-anak belajar yang tidak usia 17 atau 19, dan mohon kamu pasang telinga dan dengarkan baik-baik. Apalagi
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam
gave us the opening statement.
He said,
Hadith of the Sunnah of Tirmidhi.
He said,
and my teacher, Mawlana Dr. Muhammad Fadhlur Rahman Ansari rahimahullah, he used to teach us this hadith regularly.
He said, اِتَّقُوا فِرَاسَةَ الْمُؤْمِنِ
فَإِنَّهُ يَنْزُرُ بِدُّوِ
اللَّهِ. He said, fear
the spiritual wisdom and the spiritual insight of the one who has iman.
Because when he sees with the door of Allah.
Mendengar sebuah hadis dari Sunan Tirmidzi dan guru saya dulu selalu menegaskan hadis ini kepada kami yang berkeluargaan. Bertakwalah dengan ketaatan Islam. Orang yang punya iman, karena kalau orang yang punya iman itu bisa mengerti dengan kau, maka dia mengerti dengan nur dari Allah.
In the same way, therefore, that the external eyes need light with which to see, so too the internal eyes need light with which to see. Where does that light come from?
Bagaimana makhluk menurunkan sinar cahaya pada dapat melihat? Demikian juga makhluk menurunkan nur untuk melihat. Bagaimana mendapatkan nur itu?
Before we answer that question, I have to tell you something that's going to hurt you. Yes. But it's better that I tell you so you can wake up. It is far, far, far more difficult for you living in Singapore to get that low than it is for many others. For them it is difficult. But for you it is far more difficult. Having said that, now let us turn to the answer. From where does that low come?
Dalam saat cepat mengarahkan sesuatu akan perjalanan menyakit diri Anda, tapi juga saya mengarahkan ini ke Anda diri Anda. Ada jauh lebih susah untuk Anda yang tinggal di Singapura mendapatkan nur itu daripada orang lain. Jauh lebih susah. Sekarang saya sudah mengarahkan itu. Sekarang kita bicarakan dari mana dapatkan nur.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the question. And he answers it in a surah which is named Surah An-Nur. And he answers it in an ayah which is known as Ayat An-Nur. In order for us to explain that ayah, we ask that you kindly take off the lights. We can put on this back.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala menjawab persoalan ini dan jawabnya diberikan dalam surat An-Nur dengan ayat ayat An-Nur. Dan untuk menjelaskan sejelas-jelasnya, kami memohon agar kita sudah sendiri sekejap memanfaatkan dalam ulang ini. Kalau memanfaatkan dalam ulang ini sekejap saja.